Hello and what is going on today, guys? Tomcat here and welcome back to Need for Speed Heat, where we are going to be doing some customization and some performance customization, a build on this Ferrari F40, and then we're going to be taking it out in tonight. We're going to be doing a race, and then we're also going to be getting into a cop chase that goes up to heat level 3. So you'll see some points in the cop chase where I actually like will actively turn around and, you know, make sure that the cops keep chasing me. But looking back on it now, there were a lot of instances where I probably didn't need to, and they probably would have found me anyway. Because again, you'll see in this particular video that the cops are super, super smart. And for example, later on, you'll see there was a point at which we were going along the train tracks, and one of the tracks was blocked by a train, and the other side was barricaded in by the edge of a bridge. Well, the cop actually got in front of me and turned his car sideways so as to create a makeshift roadblock right there in front of me to get my car stopped. That is another level. That is another level on top of stuff that we've never really like seen before in terms of cop intelligence in a Need for Speed game, and I really, really, really dig it. And I'm also quite impressed with how much they allowed you to customize the F40. I did not think that the F40 was going to have this much, this many options in terms of customization. And yes, I know I did get rid of the pop-ups, but you know what? Competition spec. I'm always down for the competition spec stuff, and you know, I'm sure there's gonna be people out there that are gonna call me like, you know, the worst person in the world because I got rid of the pop-ups, but you know, sometimes I like pop-ups and sometimes I'm not a fan of them, and this particular moment was one of those times where I was like, you know what, we're gonna run without the pop-ups this time and gonna try to go for a little bit more of a race car spec. Now, that particular diffuser looked perfect to me. It fit right into the rear, like right into the rear of the stock bumper, and it just molded to it so well. And then for the wing, you can actually go for this very, very race car style competition wing, which I threw on there immediately, like, and I'm talking like immediately, like I had to have that thing on there. Now visually, that's about all that I wanted to do. Wheels wise, I wanted to leave the wheels that came on it because you can't really get rid of these wheels. I mean, you could, but at the end of the day, I was like, do I want to though? I mean, I could get rid of these wheels, but do I really want to? They really do make the car. Now, I wanted to go through and upgrade everything that I could, as far out as I could, like basically do the best upgrades I possibly could with the parts I was given. So I kind of wanted to, like I said, like dive into the parts selection as much as possible and go for as much of a grip focused build as possible. And as you can see right now, the handling square is like right in the corner between road and race, and throwing these track tires on it only makes it stickier. So with that being said, this thing was properly sticky. And when I say, like, you know, this thing was a grip build, this thing was a freaking grip build, and it really, really performed so well in terms of grip. I mean, this thing has incredible turn-in. It has incredible just, like, grip in general. I mean, you'll see later on when we were actually in the police chase, we came up on a couple of drift zones, and I tried drifting them, and it was, well, let's say drifting doesn't really work all that well in this car. I mean, it'll still let you slide it, but nowhere near the extent of a car that has a drift suspension, drift tires, you know, something like that. It's definitely not a drift-focused setup at all. I mean, it is far from a drift-focused setup, actually. And you could really tell. You could really feel it in the way the car drives. Now, I was kind of flipping back and forth here, and I was like, yeah, we're going out in tonight. I was pretty determined at this point to go and find some cops and to go and, like, you know, kind of get myself into a little bit of trouble with this thing because, you know, at this point in playing the game, I was like, you know what? I have an iconic supercar. I'm in basically, like, you know, basically Miami. I'm going to go and basically, you know, create some havoc with the cops, you know, as if it was the same time period that this car had originated in. So I think it's really cool. There was this custom Evo 10 just like chilling around by the garage. I was like, ooh, that's cool. But when you leave the garage and sometimes you'll see people like chilling around by the garage, it's kind of like, huh, I'm not alone in this world, am I? But it's one of those things where, like, you see people, you know, driving around, and you're like, that's cool. Now, this particular car just sounds so good. I mean, the way it sounds in this game, it honestly just, like, blows so many other cars out of the water. I mean, again, I'm constantly realizing over and over and over again how big of a fan I am of the sounds in this game. Just in general, I'm a fan of the sounds, and I think the sounds really go a long way to making this game what it is. And also, jumping into this race, you know, we see a lot of different things, like we saw an S15, FDR X7, A45 AMG, we saw Focus RS out here in front, and then this thing, I mean, you can see, you can whip it sideways a little bit if you want, but my god, the pace that this thing can carry is absolutely off the charts when it comes to grip stuff. I mean, I don't want to say, like, overpowered or anything, but you're ripping, that's for sure. Like, when you're driving this car in a grip environment, you are genuinely gripping, and you are ripping freaking hard. So, with, you know, at the end of the day, you've got to remember that little E30, when I said the little E30, even though it was kind of grip-focused, when I said that it drove differently than something like this, I mean, I meant it. I properly meant it. And you can see now what I did mean when I said that car in grip spec drove very differently than a much faster car in grip spec. I mean, as you can see, like, the thing on the front end on this thing is so sticky that you can just basically turn in and you're good. You're already sticking through the corner. I mean, there's really very few instances where you have to slide it. There are a couple of times when sliding it does make sense, but I mean, like, if that's more for when you know that you've waited way too long it to slow down in a corner, and you're like, I need, you know, a last resort to kind of help slow me down here or help me get around the corner, then I'll slide it. But other than that, there's really not that much of a need to slide this car, and it's just that grippy. It really is just that grippy. And I think, you know, when you drive a lot of different cars in this game, you really do start to realize that they have tuned each car differently, and they have set up each car to feel pretty dang different. I mean, this car definitely feels lightweight, it feels agile, and there's, you know, if you drive a bigger car and you drive something that with a little bit more heft to it, you'll feel that, like, oh, this feels bigger, this feels heavier, it's not going to turn in as quick, it's not going to be as agile. And again, they really have gone farther than I think I thought they would, and I think a lot of people thought they would, in terms of, you know, really making these cars feel unique. And so I was really blown away by the way this car felt, and saying that, going into that, I think it drives in such a way that people are going to like to use the cars like this. Now, as the cop chase continued, I wanted to try to get up onto the monorail track and see what would happen if I got up there. However, my first attempt didn't go so well. My second attempt, on the other hand, was much, much, much better. So stick to the left / center of that ramp and you'll be okay. I recommend sticking to the left, actually, because I almost fell off there again. And it seems to me that the cops really won't notice you up here. I mean, you could do a burnout, you could do whatever, and they'll drive by and just about not notice you. This could very well be a modern version of the bus station from Most Wanted. However, if you drop down, boom, they're right back on you again. So with that being said, you know, keep an eye out at that spot and definitely beware of what's going on at that spot. You know, but at the same time, always keep it in the back of your mind, because I think if you're in a crazy chase and you need to get out of it quick, the monorail could be a really, really, really good way to do that, because as far as I've been able to tell so far, they can't really seem to see you or get you up there. And I don't really see any cops trying to follow you off the ramp. I mean, I would like to try it, but I would like to try going off of that particular jump with a bunch of cops behind me and see if they follow me and see if any of them land up there. But I honestly don't think they would land up there. I mean, I think they would try to follow you, but I don't think they would land up there. I mean, maybe once in a blue moon, but I think all in all, it's probably a pretty reliable pretty reliable strategy if you're looking for a place to get to really get away from the cops quick. I think the monorail could really do well to be used for that. Now, heading out of the city now and heading up into the hills on the highways, the dynamic of the chase changes because at this point, cops are trying to throw themselves at you to stop you rather than trying to box you in and trying to, you know, like push you into a wall, because the dynamic of the environment changes and the dynamic of the environment that the cops have to work with also changes. Now, what I did here was I tried to do a quick U-turn and then head up through this this big interchange to see if I could confuse the cops and see if it would faze them. But as you'll see, it actually really didn't even faze them all that much. I mean, they stayed right on, well, not necessarily right on me, but they definitely knew where I went and they could definitely see me once I got around that corner. Now, this is one of the drift zones I encountered, and as you can see, if you really try to like actively drift this car, I mean, you can slide it a little bit, but nowhere near enough to be useful for drifting or useful for acquiring drift points. That's about as far as you can get from, you know, from what this car was built for, and it definitely shows. I think, you know, there's going to be people that say, well, you know, I saw it slide a couple of times in races, so that means it must just be, it must be as drifty as everything else. But when you get into an environment like this, you realize that it's nowhere near as drifty as everything else. So I think at the end of the day, there's really a big difference between the grip physics and the drift physics. And you know, when you really start to kind of dig into them a bit deeper, you realize how big of a difference there is. Now, hanging around at heat level 2, the Chargers come out, and when the Chargers come out, the chase definitely gets a little bit more intense, and they will send more reinforcements, but you do have to be careful, because I got down to the point to where I was critically damaged, and so I was actually kind of thankful that the cops weren't chasing me at this particular moment in time. And I also want to say that in the process of picking up a faster car, I realize how well suited these country highways are to the faster cars. Because if you're flying down these country highways in a supercar, it really does feel very, very natural. And I also didn't realize until it was too late that there was a cop hanging out back there by the gas station. So once that got started, I mean, there was about nothing I could do and they were on me. Now, this drift zone, I again tried to slide the car and it really was not having any of it. I mean, as you'll see, it slides out a little bit and you can kind of balance it on that balance point of slip angle, but, and we completed a daily challenge as well, but it's not going to be any sort of useful for completing these drift zones at all. I mean, you're going to definitely need to bring out a drift car, a purpose-built drift car for that stuff. Now, I was curious here to see if they would follow me off the jump and like way off of this embankment, and to my surprise, they did. They followed me off of the jump, did not knock themselves out, and actually followed me down the train bridge. And this is one of the areas where I wanted to show you guys what the cop was going to do. So if you watch up here, the left track is blocked off, and he actually wedges himself between the train and the edge of the bridge to try to create a dynamic roadblock to stop me. And that, it didn't exactly work for him, but I will say that is incredibly smart on his part, and I really, really think it's so cool that he even tried that. So digging into the more of the intelligence of the cops, I'm really, really happy with it. And I think that they're very aggressive, they're very smart, and they will try whatever they think will, you know, whatever they think will help them attempt to stop you, they will try it, and they will at least attempt to succeed with it. So it's definitely something to keep an eye on, and it's definitely something to keep in mind with these cops. Now, as we go up to heat level 3 in a couple of minutes, we're going to go into the quarry, and the quarry is a very interesting area on its own because there's all sorts of like little Easter eggs and little Easter egg jumps in there. I haven't found all of them yet, but definitely as the game gets closer to release, I'm going to attempt to find them as much as I can. Now, when you advance to heat level 3, one of the biggest things you notice is that the amount of cops chasing you at once goes up, and the amount of aggression that they use against you also goes up. So now that heat level has increased, I mean, they will literally sacrifice their cars entirely to stop you. I mean, and there's 2 more heat levels to go. So you've got to imagine that, you know, heat level 5 has to be absolutely freaking nuts if heat level 3 is this aggressive. So If you guys have any questions at all, make sure to leave them in the comment section down below. And also, if you want to stay up to date on the latest with Need for Speed Heat, make sure you subscribe to my channel. I post twice a day, every single day, sometimes more. And also, if you want to share this gameplay with your friends, please do so and share it around. I'm really, really interested in getting this game out there. And I would love to get it out there because I think a lot of people need to know how the series is evolving and how it's going in a direction that I think is extremely positive for it. And I think for fans of the series, I'm very, very excited for the future of this game. So if you guys enjoyed this video, again, make sure to leave me a like. Let me know in the comment section down below what you guys thought of it. And if you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe. And I will see you guys in the next one. Talk to you all later, and I hope you guys enjoyed.